Good evening once again, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, viewers and subscribers. It's once again time for another edition of the Midnight Cigar Review. It's about 45 minutes past the witching hour, and this evening's stick is going to be the Blanco 9. It's a dark stick, which is fitting for our witching hour review. And I have smoked this stick before, so I'm familiar with it. And the reason why I'm smoking another one is because I happen to like them. The Blanco company happens to be based here in Tampa, Florida. So without further ado, when we come back, I'll have this baby cut and already lit up. So see you in a minute. Okay, we're back. We have our Blanco 9 lit up, and it is burning absolutely perfectly even so far. As I said in the previous segment, I'm familiar with this cigar. It's actually one of my favorites. And our Blanco 9 hails from Nicaragua. It is dark brown in appearance, very dark brown. That's why I like it. The wrapper is a Habano Oscuro Corojo. Say that fast three times, how about it? The binder is Nicaraguan, and the filler is Nicaraguan as well, and it's heavy on the ligero leaves. If memory serves, it's most of the inner filler is ligero. The strength is full, and I can already tell you that this is in fact a full strength cigar. The listing on the website is accurate. This particular size here is a double Corona, which I happen to like. It's basically a Churchill. I don't know why they call it a double Corona, it's a Churchill. Again, makes a nice cloud of smoke. And one thing I like about it is, in fact, the company is based in Tampa. I try to make sure I purchase cigars as much as possible from Tampa-based companies like J.C. Newman, and now this particular one here, Blanco. And there's other cigars that I purchase that are based here in Tampa. Gio Cummels comes to mind. So, having stated all that, I'm going to continue to indulge. Oh, our movie this evening, it's not really a movie. I'm watching the fourth season of Breaking Bad, one of my favorite series, second only to The Sopranos. And our beverage is coffee, straight up coffee, no alcoholic additives included. All right, we're back. I've smoked enough of these Blanco 9s to be able to give you your smokeability factor without having to get too far down into the stick. The construction of this cigar is very nice. There's no large veins or anything of that nature. No pock marks or anything like that. It's a lighter cigar, but don't let that fool you because it is full of flavor. The burn line, every once in a while smoking these, I've had to correct the burn line now and again. Nothing major, just a little here, a little there. Now this one here, I've had to do it once already, but it wasn't bad at all. Just split second little burn, and now it's burning even again. Makes a generous amount of smoke. It burns cool. It's a cool burning cigar, but it does tend to burn a little warmer when you get towards the end because of the light nature of the cigar. Burn speed is slow. I've had some slower, some faster. It's right in the middle. The draw, this one thing I like about this cigar is the draw. The draw is a little loose of perfect, and that's the way I like that. You gotta be careful. Sometimes when a cigar has too loose a draw, it won't burn properly. Not the case with this one. The price point on this cigar, I paid about $7. No, I'm sorry, that was for the Toro. I paid $8 even for this, and it is in fact what they call a double Corona, which is basically a Churchill. The pull count was two shorts and one long as usual, and the pull rate is about every 60 seconds. Now the flavor. Some cigars advertise about how they can kick you in the butt. You better be sitting down to smoke this, you know, so forth and so on. This baby really does pack a punch because of the inclusion of the ligero leaves in it. I'm not sure, I can't remember, but I'm pretty sure that it's like almost 100% ligero leaves. And you can tell when you smoke it. But even having said that, it's still very smooth and refined. It's a very well-made cigar. The cap is well-made. Just everything is very nicely done with this stick. And I think I mentioned earlier, maybe not, the Blanco Cigar Company is based right here in Tampa, Florida. I like to try to support my local cigar makers. And even if it wasn't local, I would still buy them because I happen to really like this cigar. So, having said all that, got a little long-winded there, sorry. I'm going to go back to smoking my Blanco 9, watching Breaking Bad, the fourth season, and drinking my coffee, and we'll come back with a summary. Oh, by the way, these do come in different sizes. The only size I've seen, though, is the Churchill and the Toro, and I think it comes in a Robusto, I'm not sure. So, any event, we'll be back. Okay, we're going to wrap this up because I want to finish enjoying this Blanco 9 and watching the final episodes of the fourth season of Breaking Bad. So, to summarize, how do I like this stick? Obviously, I've already mentioned that this isn't my first one. I like it a lot. That's why I buy them every once in a while. The price point, again, on this particular cigar, the double Corona size was about $8. At my local brick and mortar. Availability, you can find them online relatively easy, but at your local cigar shop, it may be a little difficult. This isn't one of the most popular brands out there. It's the Blanco Cigar Company. It's not one of the biggest companies around. But, however, this is one fantastic stick and one I highly recommend, especially if you like a stronger flavored cigar. So that pretty much wraps it up, I would imagine. I hope you enjoyed our video review of the Blanco 9. And without further ado, long ashes, everybody, and salute.